Still me burping in the background. Now, this is a Fuller's Vintage Ale, limited edition. And I'll read the thing on the back, because this is, I think I had one, I don't know if it was a 2010 or something, but I had it on camera and I had it green as green can be. It's like, with a vintage ale, green is like, you know, it's, anything under a couple of years is green, really. A vintage ale is brewed specifically to be at its best years down the line, you know, and it will be harsh and green. It will be harsh and kind of imbalanced if you have it before at least a couple of years. You want to have it a few years down the line. So this one is 2012. It's 2015 now. It's a few years down the line. Should be, you know, getting there. I'd kind of suggest myself, I'd say like 7 years or something like that, you know. But what am I to know? Anyway, they will have, this is the ridiculous thing, quite often they have a sell-by date on them that is like too young to even drink it. Or a drink by date or stuff like that, you know. Has it got one on this? Yeah. Best before end of 2015. Really, if you're drinking it, you're drinking it 2015, this is semi-young, you know. Anyway, that's what it looks like. It's got the little thing on the top and it's got all the thing and the batch number and everything else. Like, really lovely stuff. And that's all that. Can I put it there for a little while so you can read it to, in your own time and that. Because you've seen squiggly writing, cursive, and I curse at cursive because I'm dyslexic. So I have to get someone to translate cursive for me a lot of the time. Unless it's really big, and then my eyes kind of go, oh, right, okay. But my eyes don't see cursive very well. So I'm not going to read the back. Hopefully yous have done. I'm going to peel that off. Right there. I always wonder around these. Does that make it burglar proof? And that, does that mean that if I then resealed that with some of my own brew or something like that, you know, I couldn't sell that on to someone else years later, you know. But there you go, it's all good. Oh, lovely little carbonation smokies there. There's the Griffin Brewery thing, which is the proper name for Fuller's, Fuller Smith and Turner, I think it is, if I'm not much mistaken. Where's my glass? There it is. Right, let's pour it and see how we go. Pour it down nice and smooth and carefully, because it can get, you know, a bit too far, can get a bit active. Don't get too far any more than the middle, and help it along. Get around that sort of region, because you want to tip it. Look at that head, that's lovely. Look at that. Look at the glass and everything. Look at the, let's have a tip it and see the carbonation. One minute, it's tipping towards the light. There you go. Nice dibble dibble. We're talking 8.5, which is, I think, the same region as their Golden Pride, which originally was a barley wine. I'm not sure what do they call it, an old ale now or something. Oh, that smells gorgeous. Oh, Jesus Christ. God, that smells lovely. Do you know what? These boys You know, people talk about the Trappist breweries and Westies and everything else. These boys, they make you proud. They make you want to cry almost. My chest comes up like this, you know. Make you so proud to be British, isn't it? These are the good things of this country. They really are. You know, we don't make tellies anymore and things like that. We don't make cars. We don't make, well, we do kind of like, you know, certain cars, but we make very little nowadays, and especially we don't make much that we can go, I'm really proud of that. But certain things like this, you, God blimey, can you puff your chest up. That is really, really glorious smells now. I'm going to have to tell you what these smells are now. I'm going to have to do it quickly because I'm running out of time. Oh, right. Beautiful balance. I think I've got it just right here. Close your eyes sometimes if you're having trouble. God. If you, oh, it's lovely. Just smell it. If you're ever having troubles like catching aromas and catching tastes, close your eyes. Let your mind, let it draw you by the nose hook, and draw you along to little points in your life and things. You'll go, God, that reminds me of the beach, and that reminds me of the so and so, and that, you know, things like that. And that reminds me of Nan and Granddad's house, and that, you know, oh. Going round when she's doing this and cooking that, and when Granddad's out working on it, and you, God, that sort of thing. God, you've got little berry notes in there. Right, let's see if I can bring it down emotionally, yeah? Because I'm like, ooh, like that, and I, yeah, kind of almost like gibbery at the throat and that. Right, that's glorious. I think they sell these pre-aged already, you know, pre-vintaged, and you can buy them all the way down the vintages. Do so if they do, because they're worth it whatever they cost. If you're having trouble with smells as well, put your lips on that lip on the glass. Bury your head right up to it, tip it a bit. Give it a 12 first. You're getting black currants, you're getting sherbet, you're getting little hints of wood, little hints of vanilla, you're getting little hints of toffee, caramel. This is going to sound really weird, but caramelised scallops, whatever you want to call them. You know when you've just done them right in the pan and they've got that sweet, sugary caramelisation going on. That sort of, that slight hint of that, just a little slight hint of that. Oh, licorice, star anise, little fennel notes in there. Oh, sorry, I just tasted it. Little dried strawberry notes, little nutty notes, cashews, pistachios, hot chestnuts. Oh man. Big bouncy toffee, lovely toffee, toast, hot Weetabix. Just, oh, God, it's glorious. It's going. Cheers. Oh, don't do what I just done. Just gulp. You will, but try not to. Try to hold back and try to pull the glass away and your lips come out like that. Because it's sucking you towards the glass. Oh, that is something else. That is something else. You can taste the strength of the alcohol, but it's not there. It's not an elephant in a tutu. It's not a great big clumsy thing. It's sitting there picking up all those toffee notes and all those little hot chestnut notes and all those little toast, slightly burnt toast notes and marmalades and things like that, and bringing them all to you and just going there and bringing them all up and gathering them up and going, there you go, and lovingly, gently just massaging them on your palate and on your tongue. It's effing marvellous. That is absolutely marvellous. Right, I'm going to show you the box first. Bum 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 bum. One of the best beers you're ever likely to buy for a long while. That the 2012 is absolutely extraordinary. It really is. So once again, bum 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 bum. Wow. I ain't gonna say buy it, try it and like it. Buy it and try it and bloody love it. You will love it. That is extraordinary, yeah, it really is. So anyway, listen, I'll see you in the next one. Don't be late, because I will start without you. That is extraordinary. Pardon me. Limited edition. Drink it. Best before end of 2015. Well, I will take their word for that. Because I can't imagine that being any better. That's so well balanced. That is so bang on. If I'd have had it before, it would have been a bit too much of this and too sharp and bits and, you know, there's little like sherbet-y notes and things in there. But it's so well balanced and that's awesome. I'm going to try it with the second pour just before we go off camera, because I'm hoping there's going to be yeast in there. I believe there is. Oh! Not really much. Tiniest clouding. Tiniest of clouding. Wait a minute. You can still see my fingers through there, can't you? Just the tiniest of clouding. You're even getting little slight banana notes in the background. Cool, plantain and all that. One quick one. Good Lord. Even better on the palate. Keep an eye, because some may have more yeast than others and everything else. But I'm pretty sure. Now, let's see if I can show you this, because I'm running out of time. If I do just suddenly go off, do forgive me. Now, can you see? No, you can't, can you? Can you see? One minute. Yes, you can. One minute, can you? No. Other way? No, you can't. One minute. You will. I'm going to... One minute. There. Can you... There, look. Can you see just... I don't know if you can. I'll go right up to the camera. Yeah, just a smearing of yeast. See, it's smearing. It's not like a big load of you. It's not like a big load of it. It's just a smearing of yeast. And that is proper good bottlemanship and that, you know. That's fantastic. That is fantastic. Well, Fuller's, that is brilliant. Thank you very, very much for doing a great job with that. Cheers, bottoms up. And what we got, John Keeling. John Keeling, the day I meet that man and have a chat with him, I'm going to mount his leg, I'm telling you. Right, cheers everyone. Bottoms up, chin chin. Cheers. I'm going to take my time on that. Billy billy boo. See you in the next one. Don't be late. I will start without you. You know it.